One of the biggest mistakes that a relatively inexperienced system builder will make is to place all of the component focus on the most powerful processor, motherboard, and graphics card, while trying to save money on the power supply, often purchasing a no-name brand from China. When I'm building a new rig, I generally work out the power I will need first, then buy the best power supply I can afford, while leaving enough headroom for a possible upgrade. If you have a case with a windowed side panel and are focusing on a tidy system build, then you will more than likely want to buy a modular power supply. There are several kinds of modular power supplies available today. A pure modular power supply will have absolutely no hardwired cables. This means when you open the box and remove the power supply, there won't be any cables dangling from the unit itself, and a bag will be supplied with every cable in it. Other modular or semi-modular power supplies will have some cables hardwired into the chassis. These hardwired cables will often be the main motherboard connector and perhaps a couple of PCIe cables and the CPU 8-pin. These primary cables are generally used all the time. If you don't buy a modular power supply though, then you will end up dealing with a plethora of cables you might not be using. All of these will need to be carefully routed out of sight behind the motherboard tray. Depending on the case you're using and the specific power supply, then this can get messy. Many computer cases, for instance, don't have a lot of space behind the motherboard tray, so you will need to get creative. If cable management is a high priority for you, we advise you opt for one of the modular power supplies currently available online. That means you won't be trying to hide a snake's nest of cables you don't need. We've seen many manufacturers move away from these hardwired units as we move into 2024, but they are still fairly common in the budget sector. Don't just blindly purchase a power supply with a 1250 watt or higher output rating, especially if it's in the bargain basement section on some dodgy website. Many gaming systems will likely only be demanding between 400 and 650 watts under load. Also, with a little research, it's possible to actually analyze the power demand of the hardware you are using in your system and work from there. While it is true that some high-end graphics cards, such as Nvidia's RTX 4090, can still demand more than 500 watts on their own, a more modest offering such as AMD's RX 7800 XT will demand closer to 250 watts. If you do own a high-end Nvidia 4090 though, you could see system power draw at the wall between 650 and 800 watts, depending on the processor being used. For those interested in a quick trip down memory lane, when we reviewed a system featuring two R9 295 X2 graphics cards back in 2014, well, this system demanded close to 1,200 watts at the wall. So, how much power do you really need? A good example is that a high-end gaming system utilizing a Core i7 processor with Nvidia RTX 4070 Ti graphics is likely to only be demanding between 400 and 500 watts of power under load. Many people would just think that because a system is using a high-end graphics card, that a 1500 watt power supply is immediately needed. It is also worth bearing in mind that lesser brands with high wattage ratings will not be delivering the same quality of power as a well-implemented design. Don't be immediately fooled by higher figures on a box. If you have a system that uses 600 watts of power when gaming under load, then a 1000 watt power supply is actually a pretty shrewd investment. Because you'll be hitting around 60% demand under full load, this means the power supply will be operating at or close to maximum efficiency. Noise levels will also be lower as the fan will be spinning relatively slowly. The capacitors specified to deliver 1000 watts will also be less stressed. So, to clarify, a power supply will reach maximum efficiency between 40 and 60% of its maximum rated load. We always recommend leaving a little headroom as well in case you want to add additional hardware at a later date. Ideally, you don't want to be running a power supply at above 80% full output on a regular basis. Not only will it be operating outside maximum efficiency parameters, but the fan will likely be working much harder to maintain the thermal curve. A faster spinning fan means more noise, which most of us want to avoid. Obviously though, this is only part of the procedure for buying the right power supply. You can also factor in the 80 plus certification. This is the certification of rated efficiency and certifies products that have more than 80% energy efficiency at 20%, 50% and 100% of rated load, and a power factor of 0.9 or greater at 100% load. That is, such power supplies will waste 20% or less electric energy as heat at these specified load levels, thus reducing electricity use and bills compared to less efficient power supplies. KitGuru recommends at least 80 plus gold certification, and when you spend more money, this will increase to platinum and even titanium certification. Platinum and particularly titanium power supplies are still very expensive. 80 plus gold units, though, have proven popular with the enthusiast audience over the last 5 years, as they combine high levels of efficiency at a reasonable price point. Be aware though that some power supplies don't achieve their claimed efficiency levels. There have been many articles on this in the past, and it certainly complicates the issue. Just because you see an 80 plus gold badge on the front of the box doesn't mean the power supply has actually been certified. That said, as an example, all of the Seasonic power supplies we have tested in recent years have achieved their efficiency rating. Ripple performance is also an important factor when deciding on a power supply, because if a specific unit falls outside industry tolerance specifications, it can be potentially dangerous. Ripple occurs with all SMPSUs, which are switch mode power supply units. These are tiny fluctuations in a power supply's output voltage in the order of tens of millivolts, millions of times a second. Ripple is measured as a peak-to-peak value in millivolts and is measured using an oscilloscope. We detail this and more in all KitGuru power supply reviews. A power supply that shows ripple higher than is listed by the ATX specifications can potentially cause hardware damage. There is no way of measuring when a problem might occur, but it is very possible something will go wrong in the longer term. A power supply that shows good ripple suppression, though, will help aid hardware longevity. Ripple can also have a negative impact on electrolytic capacitors. A ripple reading close to a capacitor's rated ripple will potentially shorten the lifespan, and ripple exceeding its rated level could cause it to blow. It is worth pointing out that electrolytic capacitors are found on a motherboard, a graphics card, the power supply, and more, so the potential for damage is high. Using a power supply with good ripple suppression is very important. Additionally, if you're trying to build a quiet system, then it's vital to factor in the fan performance of the power supply. A fan that has to work hard to maintain good internal temperatures will likely produce a lot of noise, which can be distracting, especially if the rest of your system has been built with silence in mind. This is another key area of testing as part of our reviews. Here now are some of the power supplies we have reviewed in 2023 that have scored the highest in our lab analysis. For more details, check out the main kitguru.net website and click into the power supply review section. At 850 watts then, we recommend the Silverstone Hella Series 850R power supply. This unit is created in conjunction with their partner High Power, and it is platinum rated. It adopts high quality 105C rated capacitors from respected Japanese brand Rubicon. The primary side is APFC, half bridge and LLC converter. This is a really quiet unit as well, and is on sale in the UK for around £220. At 1000 watts, we recommend the Seasonic Focus GX1000 power supply. This is a more affordable 80 plus gold rated unit priced at around the £170 mark. This power supply was able to deliver close to 1150 watts before safely shutting down. It ships with 105C rated high grade capacitors from respected Japanese brands Nippon Chemicon and Nishikon. Seasonic themselves also don't rely on any OEM partner, they design and create all their own power supplies from the ground up. Ripple suppression also rates as excellent, and the high quality fluid dynamic bearing fan from Honghua helps ensure longevity. Another of the key talking points is the small physical footprint at just 140mm, ensuring this will easily fit into a variety of cases on the market today. You can buy the Focus GX1000 in the UK for around £170. Increasing to 1200 watts, we recommend the FSP Hydro PTMX Pro 1200 watt power supply. This is another highly specified, platinum rated, fully modular unit designed and built in-house by FSP themselves. The unit adopts a well-cooled layout and quality components throughout both primary and secondary stages. FSP are using 105C rated Japanese capacitors from Nippon Chemicon, so no corners are being cut. The unit also achieved platinum efficiency ratings, topping out at around 95% in our testing. Ripple suppression is also excellent, falling well within industry parameters, peaking at only 25 millivolts at full load on the 12 volt rail. This is another really quiet unit too, with the fan remaining almost silent up to loads of 500 watts. FSP did opt for a reasonably aggressive fan profile, but they did achieve a fairly balanced level, ensuring good airflow in warmer, more humid environments. The only negative with FSP power supplies is poor availability in many regions. We always receive emails and public posts on our social media asking where to buy FSP power supplies. FSP have told us several times in the past that they are trying their best to improve distribution, but it still seems to be an ongoing issue. This power supply though is one of the best available today, and if you do manage to find one, consider yourself very fortunate. Lastly, at 1600 watts, we recommend the Seasonic Prime TX1600 Titanium Power Supply. We reviewed this monster back in July, and it walked away with a highest must-have award. This power supply is certainly not messing around. It measures 210mm long and won't fit in many smaller cases on the market today. Internally though, Seasonic is cutting absolutely no corners as it is crammed with high quality components. Seasonic's choice of 105C rated capacitors also showcases this serious intent, and the unit is actually packed with three massive 820 microfarad capacitors from Nippon Chemicon for a staggering total output of 2460 microfarad. This is even significantly higher output than the 2022 version of this power supply, which we reviewed back in September 22. Due to this massive capacity, we also noticed that Seasonic has used dual NTC thermistors rated at 20 ohms resistance with a relay for inrush protection. These are installed on a vertically mounted board into the main PCB to save on the horizontal footprint. This new version of the power supply also has upgraded power delivery capable of a peak of 3200 watts. It doesn't come cheap though, as the TX1600 Prime is on sale in the UK for £480. Just be sure to hide the credit card bill from your other half. That brings us then to the end of this guide, and we hope it has proven useful. And also be sure to check out all of our power supply content, which is available on our main website over at kitguru.net.